So everybody likes a good deal, and especially when it comes to ANC earbuds, everybody wants good performance at a great value. Today we're taking a look at an earbuds that from the specs seems to be doing everything right. Will this be any good? Welcome to a review of the Tozo NC9. Hello, my name is Sean and welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I do a lot of tech reviews as well as unboxing. And if that is something that interests you, do consider subscribing to the channel, leave a thumbs up on this video, as well as share this video to all your friends around. With that said, let's get on with a review of the Tozo NC9. We've definitely came a long way since the days of ANC, where only companies like Bose or Sony are offering something good. But today we're seeing more and more companies coming out with ANC earbuds, and they are all really good. Tozo have reached out to me to ask me to check out one of their latest ANC earbuds, the Tozo NC9. Although they have sent me these earbuds, I will still be providing my honest opinion so you know what you're getting into before buying these earbuds. These earbuds retails in Malaysia for about 250 Malaysian ringgit, and that translates to about US 60. And for an ANC earbuds, this is definitely on the cheaper end of things, competing directly with earbuds such as the Edifier TWS-NB2 and the Orkey EPN5. The Edifier comes in at 349 and the EPN5 retails for about 299. So if you're interested in getting these earbuds, do check out some of my links in the description below, and it'll definitely help out the channel a lot. From when you first see the Tozo NC9, the first impression that it gives you is that it is your run-of-the-mill earbuds with nothing too impressive to talk about, and the outlook of it is what you need to look past, because man, these earbuds are good. So starting with the outlook of the case, it's really nothing special, and the NC9 comes with your typical TWS case, and the case is made of a fairly high quality hard plastic case and isn't the type of plastic that easily scratch. At the top you see the Tozo logo with a white font, not the classiest but definitely gets the brand across. So at the front of the case you'll see 4 LED indicators that tells you the battery of the case itself, and if you flip the case to the back you see a nice USB Type-C charge port for you to charge up your earbuds. So the hinge of the lid is made of a friction hinge which holds itself in place very nicely and doesn't slam shut when you tilt them around, so definitely a very great feature and makes the earbuds feel a lot more premium than it needs to be. And inside the case you see the earbuds sitting nice and snugly inside, and they are held on by a pretty strong magnet. The earbuds of the Tozo NC9 is shaped similarly to most IEM style earbuds, and at the back of it you'll see very nice contours on the inside of the earbuds to try to hook on to your ears as best as it could. The touch sensor part of the earbuds is made of the same hard plastic as the case, but the interior of the earbuds is made of the glossy black plastic, which is extremely nice. Apart from that, the outside of the earbuds you'll see a microphone, which we'll talk more about it later, and also you see an LED indicator on the outside of the earbuds which is bright but will turn off once you start playing any media. The earbuds, like most IEM shaped earbuds, fits me really well. The earbuds itself might be on the bigger side, and if you have smaller ears you might find it hanging out of your ears a little bit. And finding the right ear tip shouldn't be too difficult, since Tozo gives you 6 total pairs of ear tips to choose from. And lastly, Tozo claims that the earbuds will give you a total of 8 hours of continuous playback time, and the case will give you a 2x charge cycle, which brings the total up to about 24 hours. And of course, this also depends on the volume that you play your earbuds at, so the louder you play, the shorter the battery life. The earbuds and the case takes about 1.5 hours to fully charge. So similar to most modern earbuds, the Tozo NC9 features a Bluetooth 5.0 chipset, but it doesn't tell us much about the specs or the codec that the NC9 uses. But instead, they list some older codecs that are featured as part of their spec. The earbuds are rated in Tozo's website to be IPX6 water resistant, and that is quite a high rating for an ANC earbud. So apart from taking this out for a swim, this earbud should be sufficient to protect you from sweating, working out, water splashes, and even getting caught under the rain. The NC9 also supports a super seamless mono and stereo switching mode, and it works pretty nicely. So putting either side of the earbuds into the case doesn't pause the music, and once you take them out of the case and put it back into your ears, it's boot up and ready to go. One thing I noticed on my copy of the NC9 is that I get occasional dropouts in connection, specifically on my right earbuds. So every now and then the right side will break and comes back on. Doesn't really bother me too much, but it's something I think is worth pointing out. The ANC of the NC9 is also pretty good for mid-range earbuds, not the best out there, but definitely one of the better ones. The NC9 uses a hybrid ANC technology where one mic outside here listens to the outside noises of the ear, and there is another microphone which is at the tip of the earphones right here, which picks up noises inside of your ears and creates a negative wave to cancel all of them out as much as possible. I would say that the ANC on these earbuds does a pretty good job, but the caveat is that you need to find that ear tips that fits you before any of these ANC would make sense. Similar to all ANC earbuds, a bad fit will result in the ANC not working to its best. So personally, if the AirPods Pro cuts out about 80% of ambient noise and the Edifier TWS NB2 cuts out about 75% of ambient noise, I would say the Tozo NC9 does a decent performance of about 70%. Trying this on a high speed road while commuting does cut off most of the road noise, but for most high pitched chatters or speech, it does bring down their volume a little but doesn't cancel them out altogether. So one more great thing that I absolutely love is the ambient mode, and the ambient mode on the NC9 is very linear and doesn't amplify your surroundings too much, so it sounds very naturally loud. Overall, a very good performing ANC earbuds. So the sound quality of the NC9 is also very impressive. The bass on these earbuds are really deep and rumbling, but does a good job retaining the mids and highs as well. This means you get lots of powerful rumbling bass, and the clarity is also really good. Vocals is also very clear, but you can hear that it takes a little bit of the backstage and it's not as bright as you wish it would. But for a single 9.2mm dynamic driver, it really does a good job. The soundstage of these earbuds are decent, and because of the slightly larger driver, this gives you a slightly wider soundstage, so pretty nice using this for videos and movies. And the comm quality of the Tozo NC9 is also fantastic, and it's really clear when using them in quiet or noisy environment. Tozo has been very humble with all this spec and simply says that the NC9 gives you clear calls, and I really think it does that perfectly. Anyway, let's take a listen to the call quality test of these earbuds.
So this is a test to see if the Tozo NC9 is a good earbud for making phone calls. So this is me speaking in a relatively quiet environment, and this is the call quality that you can expect. So what I'm going to do now is turn on a simulated background noise so you can hear the difference. So now there is a simulated background noise playing in the background, and this is the call quality that you can expect. So what do you think of the call quality? Let me know in the comment section down below.
The Bluetooth 5.0 chipset on the NC9 is also quite good, and watching videos on YouTube or Netflix is smooth and there is no noticeable lag. Gaming is also really nice. There will still be a minor lag there, but it's actually one of the better Bluetooth 5.0 earbuds I've used for gaming. Anyway, let's take a look at the latency performance of these earbuds.
So this is a test to see whether or not these earphones actually have a latency problem. So what I'm going to do now is clap into the microphone and you should be able to tell. So here we go. Synchronized with the sound, then you will know that these earphones actually have a latency problem.
So the NC9 also provides you with a very comprehensive set of controls, which also includes volume control. To toggle between ANC mode and transparency mode, simply tap once on the left side of the earbuds and you'll toggle between the two different modes. To play or pause media or to answer phone calls, simply tap once on the right side of the earbuds and that should play or pause your media. So to skip tracks forward, simply tap twice on the right earbuds and it should skip your track forward, and to skip backwards, simply double tap on the left earbuds. So there you go. To call your assistant, simply tap 3 times on either side of the earbuds and it will call out your assistant. So there you go, call out your assistant. And lastly, to control the volume up and down, simply tap and hold on the right side of the earbuds to volume up and tap on the left side of the earbuds to volume down. So this is another good example of earbuds controls from a fantastic simple earbuds. So what I learned from this review is to not let the normal looking outlook dictate how an earbuds will perform. And I truly am surprised with what the NC9 can offer. Apart from the occasional drop in connection on my right earbuds, everything else seems to just hit the right buttons. So that is it for this review, and if you find this video helpful, smash that thumbs up button, share this video everywhere, and if you haven't yet subscribed, do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.